You don't have to be a runner for long before you hear the word lactate threshold. Let's talk about what is the lactate threshold and how you can improve yours. Essentially, in a nutshell, the lactate threshold is the point or the pace where your production of lactic acid is greater than your body's ability to clear it, to deal with it. If you see this graph, lactate levels from the runner, that's low at slower speeds, and somewhere around 1 hour race pace for all runners, that's where we see this crossing of the lactate threshold, after which we see lactate build up very quickly in the blood. 1 hour race pace may seem like an odd distance to know, but I've actually made it easy for you in the McMillan Running Calculator. Just go to the calculator, put in your information, click on training paces, and you'll see the estimate for your lactate threshold pace listed right there. That's something that you'll see improve as your training improves and as your racing improves. Now, the crux of the lactate threshold comes down to the fact that our body works like a hybrid car. We've got lots of different engines available to produce energy. We call them energy pathways in exercise science. Now, one of these engines or pathways converts carbohydrate to energy, but does not require oxygen. So it's anaerobic. It's an anaerobic breakdown of carbohydrate to produce energy. The byproduct of that energy pathway is lactic acid. As you run faster and faster, that engine provides more and more, it contributes more and more of the energy, and as a result, you produce more and more lactic acid, and at some point, you produce more than you can clear. Even as you're watching this video, you are producing some lactic acid. It's just that your body has a mechanism to be able to clear that. Now, you probably have heard that lactic acid is not all bad. It's really two components. It's a molecule that has two components. It has a lactate part of the molecule, and then it has a hydrogen ion. So the lactate is actually a fuel. It can be used by the adjacent muscle fibers. It can be used by the heart. It can be used by the brain. And we have a system that shuttles this lactate. Once lactic acid is produced, it immediately breaks into a lactate molecule and the hydrogen ion. That lactate molecule can quickly be shuttled to these other places for use. Now, the other component, the acid component, the hydrogen ion, that's what causes acidity to rise in your muscles. That's what makes it bad, because our muscle contractions can only occur in a narrow range of acidity. If it gets too acidic, your muscles can't contract correctly. You'll see this at the end of races, particularly shorter races like a 400 meters, 800 meters, or a mile race, where those athletes are really struggling to get their muscles to work. That's because the muscles have become too acidic. They don't operate very well in that environment, and that's why improving your lactate threshold can help you with longer distance races as well as shorter distance races. Training that I'll describe in just a minute works to improve the shuttling of that lactate away. It also helps improve the buffering of the acidity. That buffering of the acidity allows you then not to have an interference with your muscle contractions. When both of those things occur, the speed of your lactate threshold improves. Once that speed improves, you race faster. In fact, when I was in graduate school, it was kind of found out that the most important, or at least certainly one of the most important performance predictors, was the pace at your lactate threshold. If you improve that pace at your lactate threshold, you will race faster. As a result, then coaches said, well, then we need to put a lot of emphasis on that type of training. That's where you saw the introduction of the tempo run become very, very popular in training systems. The tempo run is a continuous run that is done right at the lactate threshold, as you can see in this graph here. I will caution that there, you know, like most things, you can have too much of a good thing. And this is what I see a lot in runners, is that they do continual lactate threshold training week after week after week after week. And really, that system can fatigue after 10 to 12 weeks. And many runners experience this. They start doing tempo runs. their pace improves and then it plateaus and then they sort of fatigue that system. It doesn't continue to improve. What I did in graduate school when I was studying the lactate threshold was I really looked at training history, a lot of the research I was getting, and what I found was that variety in training the lactate threshold is the way to go. I call it full spectrum lactate threshold training. You certainly can do the tempo run as we described, and this is what a lot of training programs have, the workouts that are done right at the lactate threshold. But really, what I found, and I think a lot of coaches through history have found this, is that variety is the spice of life for runners. And so doing some runs that are slightly slower than the lactate threshold, we call those steady state runs or sub-threshold runs. Doing the tempo run, the standard tempo run at your threshold, tempo intervals which are a little bit faster than the lactate threshold, and then cruise intervals, which a more popular term now is called critical velocity training, is done even slightly faster. So if we look at this graph, we can see the steady state run is a little slower. The tempo run is right at the threshold. Tempo intervals just slightly faster. And then cruise intervals even slightly faster from there. Doing a combination of these types of workouts, and again, you can go to McMillanRunning.com, go to the Learn section. I've got articles on all the different training zones and types of training. There's videos on the steady state run, the tempo run, tempo intervals, and you can learn more about those. But the point is, in your training, I encourage you to have a variety of these different types of lactate threshold workouts. I find runners don't get as bored. The threshold gets a bigger boost because you're slightly challenging it in different ways instead of the same way all the time. And it makes it more fun. I can get more training out of the athletes over time. So think about that as you go forward. Now, I said that the lactate threshold pace you can get from the McMillan Running Calculator, but really effort and breathing is even more important than something like pace or heart rate or power. You really want to learn these different kind of points by doing these lactate thresholds. You want to know that the steady state run is kind of an easy medium run. You want to then go and do a medium effort run. That's kind of the tempo run. Tempo intervals kind of medium to medium hard, and then cruise intervals sort of medium hard. Start to do these different workouts and feel that effort in breathing, because it really is a threshold above which you'll notice sometimes a significant change in your breathing. Then you can correlate that back with pace or heart rate or power. And as a result, you can know the type of workout that you're doing, so you know how you should be feeling the effort versus the your breathing, and then you can adjust that appropriately. Once you dial in the effort and breathing for these workouts, and again, you can start with pace and make sure your effort and breathing is dialed in, then you can always have a great lactate threshold workout. No matter if it's hot and humid, or if it's windy, or if it's hilly, you can always put in a great effort. If you have any questions about this, let me know. I think it's a really important thing to understand in training, and with a little bit of variety, as we mentioned, with doing these different types of workouts, and that's what you'll see in my McMillan training plans. You'll see a big boost in your lactate threshold, and your racing will improve. As always, if you have any questions, let me know. Otherwise, I'll talk to you again real soon.